so I know forever after I will miss you more and more. It won't be easy.
No,
it won't be easy without you.
No, no.
Reach across the stars, let them know you're with me.
I knew the salvage game would pay off one day. Of that thing.
Can we stop it tumbling?
Hell yes.
Safely, I mean.
And get it in the hold. What about the heading?
Computer confirms it. Solar path B9436, axis 24. That trajectory will drop it into the sun.
Payday, love.
You think so?
We've got them three ways to Christmas.
What?
Well, either it's a screw-up, in which case someone wants it back, or we can haul it back for scrap.
It's not on our list of runaways, and anyway, the scrap value is probably not worth the fuel.
And last, but not our way short of least, there's the hazard to navigation premium.
It's probably a long way short of navigation too, all those commercial flights into the sun. Is that what you've got in mind? I mean, they're really going to pay us top rate for getting that thing out their way.
Marty, dear heart, we're not going to tell them exactly where we picked it up now, are we?
States Space Station, Ronald Reagan. How may we help you?
Connect me with section OMZ-13.
I'm sorry, there is no such section.
You sure? Never mind, just connect me with Dr. Goodman.
I'm sorry, there's no Dr. Goodman at this station.
Dr. Harvey Goodman?
I'm sorry.
That's nonsense. Dr. Harvey Goodman has been working on the station for the last 9 months.
There is no listing for a Dr. Harvey Goodman.
Transfer me to a human being.
The information I have given you has been checked and is correct.
God damn it! I don't want to talk to a PR graphic. Connect me with a human being. Now!
I'm Pete Lennox. How can I help you?
There's some sort of computer foul up.
Listen, ma'am, if it has to do with salary allocation, I'm going to have to ask you to be patient.
No, it's nothing like that.
Well, then maybe I can help.
I'm trying to contact Dr. Harvey Goodman. Your communications computer can't find a listing.
I'll cross-check it for you. No?
What do you mean, no?
No reference to arrival, departure, allocation of resources, nothing.
He has to be there.
Lady, you cannot come and go in these places without at least one of the machines picking up on the fact.
It's some sort of a mistake. It has to be.
Well, you have a section form, a designated work area.
OMZ-13.
Module. We don't have a Z-13. We don't have any outer modules designated 13. It's a very unlucky number, you know. Are you sure that you've got the right station?
You think I don't know where my own brother works?
Well, I can only tell you, ma'am, that he doesn't work here.
All right, Mr. Lennox. Thank you.
You're welcome, ma'am. Good day to you.
Daughter, how much longer is it going to take you to secure that bloody thing?
Naughty sweetness. If you can do it faster, get suited up and get out here. Unless you want me to pressurize the hold, of course.
Only if you found a way to give up breathing for the rest of the trip.
Didn't your mother tell you there'd be women like me?
She didn't say anything about crooked salvage deals.
Sometimes I wonder if you sincerely want to be rich. Marty, my love.
Someone somewhere is committing a crime.
What, some friend of yours?
Oh, that's very funny.
Listen, I'm going to the reception for the new base coordinator. I'll be a couple of hours. Well, are you going to ask how come they sent him out from Earth instead of nominating one of their moon-based people?
No, it's not against rules.
Well, it's against custom and practice. And the Russians never do anything without a reason.
Who does?
A subtle reason.
Well, look, if it's another bid for world domination, they're hardly likely to admit it over the fruit, juice, and soya snacks, are they? Any messages? You know where to find me.
Look, I'm supposed to be a hero, not a receptionist and filing clerk.
Oh, you've been playing back those press conference tapes again.
Yeah, well, maybe I should give another. And tell the world how our beloved leader is treating the savior of the moon shuttle.
What, you mean bent cop reinstated praise as tolerance of boss? That's the sort of thing you had in mind.
Smartass.
Mm-hmm. Chief superintendent's smartass. Unless, of course, you want to go the same way as Kirk Hubble.
Hubble was gutless and witless.
Mm, smart enough to recognize a losing hand when he was dealt one.
Meaning I'm not.
I don't know, are you?
I'll play these.
No, I had a feeling you weren't.
Listen, no one pushes me into resigning.
I'm impressed.
And in charge. And there was me thinking the good commander had no sense of humor.
Well, you're concerned, Kenzie, he doesn't.
Oh, unlike you.
Well,
you think it's all a big joke, don't you?
Frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn. But you are unique, I've got to admit that. Yes. You're absolutely the first person I ever met who enjoyed filing so much she wanted to spend the entire rest of her life doing it. Screen erase.
Oh, shuckle, chuckle. If there's one thing I need in my life to make it truly complete, it's a witty chief superintendent. Oh, the hell with it. Screen on.
Yes, Kenzie?
I wanted to warn you that I intend to resign, sir.
Fine, get a hard copy, sign it, put it on my workstation, screen off.
Reconnect. You didn't give me time to finish, Commander. What I was going to say is that I intend to resign unless you give me something more interesting to do.
Fine, get a hard copy, sign it, put it on my workstation.
So you do still intend to get rid of me?
I just don't want you to have any illusions about your future in the Star Cops.
I made a lot of good publicity out of what could have been a lot of bad publicity. That doesn't count for anything.
That's right, that doesn't count for anything. Public relations is not your job.
Well, what exactly is my job? Sitting here taking messages.
Yes.
You know this is constructive dismissal, don't you? I think the press might find your attitude very interesting.
Well, I think the press are about as reliable as you are.
Look, I'm not resigning, sir.
And just about as consistent. Well, is that it, Kenzie, or did you just call me up to play musical resignations?
Your ETA on Ronald Reagan.
2350.
You knew that already.
I was just checking, sir. Any further orders?
Yes, I don't need damn fool calls when I'm talking to the Americans. I'm going to have enough problems as it is.
You don't want me to call you at work, dear.
Don't push it, Kenzie.
What'll you do? Ruin my career?
What career? Screen off.
Approach confirm, red vector 7, docking outer lock 3-4.
Much further out and we'd be back at the main shuttle transfer.
Pardon me?
Red vector 7, outer lock 3-4, thank you.
The Star Cup's shuttle's just docking, Commander. You're gonna meet him in here?
Hell no, I've just finished for the day.
You want me to wait and guide him out to the living quarters?
He's a detective, isn't he? Let him find his own way.
Now, follow the yellow brick road.
Approaching artificial gravity.
You are now approaching artificial gravity.
Commander Spring? Pete Lennox.
Oh, Mr. Lennox.
You didn't get lost then?
Did you expect me to?
Well, it's a pretty big station. If you'd care to follow me.
Spring.
Commander Griffin.
I'm sorry I wasn't at the airlock to greet you personally.
Oh, no need to apologize. I can see you're busy.
Has Pete set up the 10-cent tour yet?
Not yet, sir. I still need to get clearance from some of the contractors. I'll get on it, if you'll excuse me.
A few of our clients are a little nervous about who sees what they're working on.
Oh, no need to frighten them on mic, huh?
We do have a high-profile, multi-use station here, but one of the few things we're not able to cope with is tourists.
No problem, I didn't bring any.
Especially foreign tourists.
Oh, yes, these Germans, they do good everywhere, don't they?
You play this game?
Not since I joined the Star Cops, no.
That was a pretty dumb move from what I heard.
Giving up pool?
I can understand you not wanting to talk about it.
On the contrary, sir, Star Cops is what I'm here to talk about.
Oh, yeah? So, how do you like our little setup, huh?
Impressive. Gravity makes all the difference.
It's the nature of the beast. We have the best of both worlds here. Work areas are weightless, of course, but rest, recreation, living quarters.
Best of an almost world, huh?
Still think like a groundsider,
yes,
huh?
It's the nature of the beast. What is the gravity here?
Oh, it's about 1/3 G. Varies a tad sometimes.
Well, doesn't that throw your game?
Table self-regulated.
Sir, yeah. She's on the circuit again.
Oh, not now, Pete.
She's very insistent.
Well, don't let me interrupt your work.
I don't plan to, man. I'll be right back.
All right, Box. How does this table work?
The table generates an electromagnetic field which the modified balls react to. The system is balanced by an analog computer.
All right. You give me an edge.
Something fishy's going on up there, and I don't like it!
I don't know what else I can tell you, Miss Goodman.
You can tell me where my brother is, that's what else you can tell me. And never mind you signaling your goddamn henchmen.
My what?
I know what you're doing.
We never heard of your brother. My henchman has been through the records from the time this station was first commissioned.
And what does that prove?
Well, it proves, ma'am, that he's never been on the administrative staff, he's never leased a work module, there has never been a Harvey Goodman here.
You'll be telling me next has never been a Harvey Goodman.
Ma'am, I do sympathize with your situation.
Yeah, the hell you do.
But you're gonna have to excuse me.
What kind of a fool do you take me for? You think I'm playing games here?
Screen off.
Sorry about that. Some woman keeps pestering us.
She's not too tightly wrapped, you know what I mean? Not playing with a full deck.
Well, if it's a problem, maybe we can deal with it for you.
Hell no, she's an American.
Yes, of course. Well, I thought I'd just make the offer.
Nice try, Commander. So, do you play this game?
I do now.
It's computer controlled, of course.
Well, my old man said, the trouble with computers is that they provide the solutions before there are the problems.
This table makes playing just like it would be in a 1G environment. Just like home.
How cozy.
Damn.
Bad luck.
It does have other applications.
Pinball? Red. Top right.
Very popular with our people. You shouldn't underestimate the importance of that.
Oh, I don't, especially as I'm not. Popular with your people, I mean. Top left. Since I sacked Inspector Hubble, your State Department can't make its mind up whether I'm the Antichrist or just anti-American.
Same thing.
Yes. Center pocket.
Hubble was an American national working for an American company.
No, he was a Star Cop working for me. Top left.
You had no right to fire him without consultation.
No, we didn't fire him. And we did consult him. He resigned.
Like Richard Nixon?
Yes, that's right. Top right.
He may have been a son of a bitch, but he was our son of a bitch.
And my country, right or wrong, eh?
There are worse philosophies.
Yes, most of them begin with that. Center pocket.
You and Thoreau should be getting on real well.
Now, why do you say that?
Your second in command's a little short on patriotism.
I knew there was something about that fellow that I liked.
Did you know he was a student radical?
Weren't we all?
No.
Oh. Well, if you're not radical as a kid, where's there to go in your reactionary old age?
Not on our space program, that's for damn sure.
Or lost, maybe.
I don't think so.
Well, he's turning out to be a good copper.
Oh, yeah, I preferred Hubble.
Hubble wasn't even a good crook. Top left.
This table's really running for you, isn't it?
Hmm.
What do you mean he wasn't a good crook?
Well, the stupid bastard got caught. I mean, if you're going to pay somebody off, it's best to make sure he's bright enough to make it worth your while.
Somebody paid him off? No, why the hell would anybody want to do anything like that?
To keep his mouth shut, I should imagine.
You don't know.
Mm. Black, top right.
You're the first person to beat me at this. I hate to be beaten.
Maybe you should choose your game more carefully.
Or my opponent.
You are Inspector Kinsey. Pal Kinsey? I've seen your news conference. I've read of your bravery. I am Alexander Krivenko. I look forward to meeting you.
Well, I'm very pleased to meet you, sir.
It has long been my view that popular entertainment has trivialized courage to the point where we no longer value it as we should.
I can't argue with that. I'm certainly undervalued.
Well, most people who come out here are they not, David?
Well, some more than others.
Everywhere there's a criminal element in all societies. This one, it's no different.
Well, where there's living, there's policemen.
The gospel according to Nathan Spring.
Ah, yes. You said Commander Spring was on...
Oh, we're working, sir.
On the Americans.
There's a problem with your countrymen?
No, sir, no problem. Just a routine meeting.
I see. So a routine meeting with the Americans is more important than a first meeting with me?
Well, sir, it's not entirely routine. There's a small problem about putting Star Cops on American stations.
Hmm. They won't let us.
I'm teasing, David. Tell me, when a crime occurs, how do you set about solving it?
Well, I guess that would...
Well, that would depend on the crime.
Yeah. Inspector Colin Davis, Dr. Alexander Krivenko. Dr. Krivenko's our
new... Our new moon base coordinator. Yes, I know. And a new spaceman, too, I think.
Well, I've worked in the field of space medicine for many years.
Yeah, but you've never been out here before.
I have come late to it. You have yourself, have you not?
You know about my background?
As you know mine.
Yes, so like Colin said, sir, it would depend upon the crime.
Yes, well, let us take a hypothetical example. Kidnapping.
For ransom?
For politics.
Well, that's not a very common crime out here for any reason.
That's why I chose it.
Well, I suppose we need to discover the purpose behind the crime.
Oh, not necessarily. Crime's a crime.
And in the case of a kidnapping, the purpose would be obvious,
yes,
surely.
If the disappearance were accompanied by a demand.
Well, let us assume a kidnapping with a demand for money. What is your first move?
Saved by the bell.
Perhaps this will be a real crime.
Screen two on. Star Cop headquarters, can I help you?
My name is Dilly Odile Goodman, and I'm calling from Earth. I want to report the disappearance of my brother.
Oh, look, we have very limited power to deal with runaways.
I'm sorry?
Well, your brother's disappeared from home. Do you think he's run away to space, is that it? How old is he?
How old is he?
I mean, have you checked with the Earthside authorities? A lot of these kids don't make it out here, you know.
What is it with you people? You are so goddamn patronizing. Is it because I'm a, what do you call it, a groundsider? Or is it just because I'm a woman?
I'm sorry, I was only trying to help.
My brother is 47 years old. He's a scientist, and he's vanished from the space station where he was working.
Well, what do they say about him?
The guys I talked to, they said he was never there. They seem to think I was some kind of a moron.
Okay, what station was this?
The Ronald Reagan.
Now I can see your method of working at first hand.
It's the main American station.
Lucky you were here, Dr. Krivenko.
Yes, indeed.
And with a hypothetical example all ready for testing.
Don't worry about that, Miss Goodman. You just give me all
disappearance,
the details,
you said.
And I'll take care of
it. No, I said kidnapping.
Brian, what was your name again?
Well, maybe that's what this is.
I just had a terrific dream about what's in that thing.
And?
We made enough out of it to buy a nice little business back on Earth.
Oh, yeah? What sort?
Agribusiness.
Agri... We don't know anything about farming.
We weren't born knowing about the scrap salvage business.
No, we spent years learning it.
Little house, roses round the door. I wonder what chicken scratching in the yard.
Years of grafting and we still can't make a straight living.
No, stop moaning.
Well, can we?
We make a living.
This you call living? And anyway, I said a straight living.
You really are a guilt-ridden little soul, aren't you?
Well, it's no fun winning if you have to cheat.
Winning's not supposed to be fun, sweetie. It's just something we have to do. It's something we're going to do in a big way.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Chickens round the door, roses scratching in the yard.
I've got a feeling, a definite feeling.
So, what was in this dream? Tell me more about it.
Oh, I don't know. All I know is it was the end of all our problems.
Why don't you come to... Yeah.
Good morning. Oh, forgive me.
Oh, hey, I'm sorry. We were supposed to start the tour about now, weren't we?
No sweat.
Yeah, I forgot how precise you Brits are about these things. Have a cup of coffee. Make yourself comfortable.
Thanks.
Did you sleep well?
Yes, yes, thank you. Gravity does make all the difference. I shall never get used to sleeping weightless.
Well, we got a couple of guys working on that problem right now.
Government research?
Hell no. They're both from pharmaceutical houses. They're probably duplicating each other's research, but what the hell? They got the funding, huh?
And do you have any government research?
Oh, there's some funding. Oh, say, what's the story on this Russian of yours?
Which Russian would that be?
Krivenko.
Well, when did he get to be my Russian?
Well, you got his predecessor fired.
Oh, well, he was a murderer. Possible murderer.
So you got the Russian's job?
It was their turn.
Yeah, but you got it for them early. They're in place 2 years early.
Well, does it matter?
Hell, it matters. We weren't ready.
Oh, I'm sorry. What were you planning? A ticker-tape parade?
Oh, they were ready, though, weren't they? They had a guy trained and waiting back on Earth.
Krivenko's a senior academician. Well, he's the Nobel Prize winner for medicine. It is mainly due to his work that you and I can come and go from Earth to space without any major bone damage.
You gotta hand it to them bastards, huh? When they give a guy deep cover, they really do a job, huh?
You think he's a spy?
Oh, that's a crude word. They're cleverer than that.
You think I'm a spy?
I think you've been used.
In other words, I'm more stupid than that.
Well, you Europeans have always been naive where those Russians are concerned.
Possibly. So what is this government research that you do?
Huh?
Saved by the bell.
Yeah.
Is the circuit open for Commander Spring, sir?
Well, I'll give you a little privacy.
Oh, no need.
Okay, I'll be in the mess room when you're ready. Oh, hey. I heard from the State Department. They turned you down flat.
Oh. I can't even replace Hubble.
Sorry.
I can see that.
What'd you expect, huh?
So much for the Allies. Box.
Yes, Nathan?
Are there any concealed computer terminals in this room?
No.
Damn it.
This is merely a primary communications console.
Commander Nathan Spring, open circuit. David, what are you still doing there?
Hi, how's it going?
Well, it's not going to be as easy as cheating at pool. Listen, aren't you supposed to be Earthside interviewing recruits?
Yeah, I'm leaving any time now. Look, there's been a small problem that's come up since you've been away.
Yes, what is it?
Well, it's not really something I can talk about over an open circuit.
Well, my mind reading is a little rusty, David.
Oh, caught you at a bad moment, huh?
Get on with it.
Look, you seem a bit tense, Nathan. They're not making you sleep in a weightless unit, are they?
Just what exactly is it that you want, David?
Kenzie is on her way to you.
She's what?
Look, she's done all the preliminary work on the case. She's got all the details.
What case? What details?
She'll explain it all to you when she gets there.
Listen, this better be important enough to justify sending that bloody woman here. I thought I made it quite clear she does not leave that desk.
You also made it clear that I was running things in your absence.
That woman is a menace.
I think the case could be too, Nathan. I think there may be some political problems.
Oh, well, in that case, Kenzie is perfect casting.
Believe me, she'll be less of an embarrassment there than I would be. You gotta trust me on this.
From here, my recruitment policy is beginning to look a little eccentric.
Listen, Nathan, I think what we're seeing here is a definite game plan. Our problem is we don't know who's coaching the play.
Dilly, that's it, that's it. You gotta learn your football.
Yeah, I know. Commander Spring,
oh,
morning.
Hey,
morning.
You ready for your little goodbye tour now?
If you'll excuse me.
Tommy, did the State Department explain why they turned us down?
They are, quote, not in favor of international policing, unquote.
Oh. Well, they were at the beginning. Until they looked up the word international, found out that it didn't just mean Americans abroad.
Well, I did warn you. Why should the United States government support an organization that is basically anti-American?
Well, the Stark Ops is basically anti-crime, Commander, nothing else.
Well, we can handle our own crime.
Well, supposing I have to prove you can't.
It'll never happen.
You're a gambling man, Commander.
Goes with the territory. You don't know that. You don't know anything about the people that come out here.
Well, ever play cards with Hubble?
I may have.
Well, don't you remember?
Can't say that I do. I played poker with a lot of guys.
Hubble must have been a pretty remarkable player, though.
Oh, yeah? Really?
Well, how else would you explain how he took so much money off people so regularly?
There you go again.
You a good poker player, Commander?
I know when to ride my luck. How about you?
I don't know. This still sounds to me like some excuse for you to get your ass out of that office.
You're the one who says them for anomalies. Well, you couldn't have a more glaring one than that, could you?
She says he's missing. You can't find any evidence that he ever existed.
He has no social welfare or security ID number. No birth, marriage, or death registration. No credit classification, no transportation licenses. No passport number or security ID. No medical, educational, or military certification.
Has she?
I ran a check on her. And a Harvey Goodman is listed as her next of kin. That's the only place he is listed.
Well, what does that prove?
Well, not very much at this stage, but don't you find it suspicious?
Well, what exactly do you think this woman is up to?
I don't know exactly, but I think she could be an agent provocateur.
Oh, I see. Or rather, I don't see. Have you checked with the people here?
No. If someone is trying to stir up trouble with the Yanks, that'd play straight into their hands.
Well, who would want to do that? As if I didn't know.
The Russian was there when the call came through. He even predicted it.
Oh, that was clever of him, wasn't it? To avoid suspicion like that.
It's arrogance. He couldn't resist playing games with us.
What did this Goodman woman say her brother was?
A microbiologist. Said he graduated from Caltech, did a postgrad at MIT.
But there's no record of it on their computers.
According to their computers, nobody called Goodman was ever at either one.
Over what period?
Ever. Or as far back as the computer records go.
Have you checked the odds on that?
What for?
Goodman isn't a particularly unusual name.
I suppose not. So?
Kenzie, you strike me as several things, but stupid is not one of them. Of all the thousands and thousands of students who have ever attended Caltech and MIT...
There should have been at least one Goodman at some time. The records have been got at.
Possibly. If somebody wanted to do a fast, dirty job...
They'd erase all references to the name Goodman and trust them nobody spotting it.
Who'd be in a position to do that?
Oh, I'm sorry, I should have thought of that.
Yes, you should have.
I said I'm sorry.
Oh, well, that makes everything all right. Now, according to the system, Goodman was a microbiologist working here. All right, where?
Where?
The people who use this station do so on what the Americans are pleased to call a say-and-pay basis. They say what work they plan to do, then they pay for the right to do it in some appropriate part.
They hire a room?
Roughly speaking.
Well, roughly speaking, the room he was supposed to have hired is called Outer Module Z13. But what's more important is that this sister claims she was told that module doesn't even exist.
Does it?
Well, I don't know yet.
Kenzie, were you planning to check any of the facts in this case?
Do you find being perfect a problem, sir?
I find being patient a problem, Kenzie.
Well, Theroux is going to interview Ms. Goodman when he's back on Earth recruiting.
Oh, well, that is always a very good first move.
I'm glad we did something right.
Too late to be of any use to this investigation and no use at all to you out here.
On a scale of 1 to 10, score -3. Or is that being overgenerous?
Depends on your next move and what you find out as a result.
Come on, let's have some coffee. I'll introduce you to John Wayne. Move. Move on.
Have you found out anything yet?
I'm sorry, sir. I'm afraid Chief Superintendent Theroux just left. You missed him by a matter of minutes.
No, that's no matter. I'm just interested in the case.
Screen off.
Must I take it you have found out nothing so far?
Well, I personally have found out that the moon is not made of green cheese and that Father Christmas don't live on the dark side.
Now you're teasing me.
Well, there's something to be said for seeing for yourself.
Yeah, well, this has always been my philosophy too. Unfortunately, it is not always possible.
Or some societies make it more possible than others.
I think you overestimate the differences, my dear Colin. Come now, what progress have you made with our case?
Forgive me, my dear Alexander, but this is not our case. It is our case.
Why are you so unfriendly?
Maybe because you're not.
Have you always been so paranoid?
Have you always been so nosy?
Curiosity is what makes me a scientist.
Suspicion is what makes me a policeman.
Then we have nothing to say to each other.
I think that just about says it all. Screen on.
Well, well, what have we here?
Oh, Commander...
Wayne?
Griffin, this is Inspector Pal Kenzie.
I'm delighted to make your acquaintance, sir.
Pleased to meet you. Have you shown your pretty assistant our pool table yet, Commander?
I'm not very good on pool tables, sir.
I'm a little bit too much of a gentleman to make the obvious comment.
But not to think it.
Well, a man's thoughts are his own.
Only if he keeps them to himself, sir.
I think I'm in love.
Can I ask you a question, sir?
Anything. You know, I'm a great believer that communication between people is enhanced by direct, tactile contact.
Hmm. Is that why you're keeping quiet, is it, sir? You don't want him holding your hand in front of all these people?
Well, perhaps that's where I've been making my mistake. Is that why we disagree, Commander? Lack of tactile contact?
I don't think that's going to be a problem between you and me now, is it?
You're taking odds.
Supposing I wanted to hire a room.
Oh, you can share mine.
And supposing I was a microbiologist and I wanted to hire a room, where would I go?
Somewhere else.
You've got something against microbiologists?
Well, there's a directive. No research involving protozoans, bacteria, none of that stuff. You see, we leave those dirty games to the Russians.
What about medical research?
Well, how do you tell the difference, huh?
The blanket ban, then, the good and the bad.
That's right. Where that stuff's concerned, when you got no place else to go, you keep it the hell away, huh? It's just too goddamn dangerous. Now, pretty lady, what do you say I show you the pool table and its more orthodox uses?
Sure.
How about you, Commander Spring?
Oh, no, thanks. I think I'll catch up on some sleep.
Right. Except no substitutes. Pool is the real American game.
Let's take a look at that module, see what we've got.
That would be dumb.
Well, give me one good reason.
Suppose it's explosive.
Well, compromise. We'll stick the video probe into the vision socket and see what we can see.
Nothing. No light.
We'll use the self-illuminating probe.
Too dim.
I want to see what's in there.
Would any of these be designated for any particular dangerous research projects? Cross-check, Dr. Harvey Goodman. Box. Are there any security codes which I don't have?
The codes you are using will access all data to which the station commander has access from this terminal.
He didn't miss any.
Is that a question?
Cross-check. Police investigation, Inspector Kirk Hubble. And if I could do that, I wouldn't be taking all these bloody stupid risks. Screen off!
Commander.
Screen's on.
I'm sorry that I startled you.
You're supposed to be keeping our host occupied.
There's only so many questions you can ask about this stupid game.
Yes, I'm having the same problem.
He wandered off. I thought I'd better come and warn you.
Keep around that hatch.
Is this file what you're looking for?
Whatever it was that Hubble had over your friend, the commander, there's no clue to it in the databanks.
Since when did he get to be my friend? And what about my missing bug specialist? Is he imaginary or not?
I'm working on it.
Anything?
Just black and noise.
Concentrate.
It's no substitute for light.
Is that any better?
Still nothing. I'm not happy about your suit telemetry, Lauter.
Stop fussing, Marty.
I just don't like the risk you're taking.
That's the best I can do.
Still nothing. Look, stop waiting, suit, air and luck, and get back in here.
Still nothing.
Nothing. Let's get out of here.
Someone's coming. Screens off.
Oh, that was very clever.
Sorry.
Lights up. Can't you do anything bloody right?
Obviously not. Would you get your hand off my leg?
I am not touching your leg.
So much for telling.
We understand each other perfectly well without it.
It's an honest mistake.
That must be a first for you.
Cheap shot.
Yes, it was. I'm sorry. Let's get out of here.
I was all keyed up expecting someone to be there.
Lights off.
Nathan, I'm still activated.
Miss Goodman? Miss Goodman? Is anybody home? Miss Goodman?
From us, Pete.
About the woman, they can't prove a thing.
Supposing they find her.
They're not that good.
I think this guy Spring is. I think he knows I paid off Hubble. I think he knows it all.
He's bluffing.
How you gonna explain bouncing that tree trunk off his man's skull?
I thought he was an intruder.
Oh, that's real convincing.
Well, he has no business here.
And you do.
I had the keys from the realtor. I'm thinking of buying the house.
From Goodman's missing sister?
So what do you suggest, sir?
All bets are off. Time to make a deal.
I believe this is yours. Let's talk.
I've been thinking about that replacement for Hubble.
You think it's a good idea?
Yeah.
Are you saying you'll support my case?
That's what I'm saying.
For three officers?
Two.
Three.
Three.
Well, I knew you were a reasonable man.
Yeah. And I take it if I support you, you'll support me.
That's what we're for.
I'm talking about the Goodman investigation.
What Goodman investigation?
So we're both reasonable men.
I'm not. The Goodman investigation is mine, and I'm not a reasonable man.
Commander Spring, we got a deal or not?
A deal? Is that what you're offering me?
Now look, you got a choice here. You can either get your organization into this station, or...
We're already in, sir.
I knew you were a reasonable man.
Yeah. And I take it if I support you, you'll support me.
That's what we're for.
I'm talking about the Goodman investigation.
What Goodman investigation?
A strategy taught to me by Commander Spring. I try to learn from my mistakes, sir. Now, would you like to tell us exactly what happened to Harvey Goodman?
With the Americans?
Screen off. He's not yet returned, sir.
Well, assuming he is still with the Americans.
Assuming you need to assume.
Do you expect him soon?
When he comes back, I'm sure you'll be the first to know, sir.
If you believe that I know everything, why do you try so hard to give nothing away?
Sir, you really don't have any right of access to this office.
Oh, come now, Colin. I am the base coordinator.
That means nothing here.
That's an interesting point of protocol.
It's a point of law.
We want to register a salvage case.
Oh, this way.
We want to clear the rights to open it.
And claim the hazard to navigation premium.
OK, screen one on reference missing modules. Right, let's have all the details. What is it, Ellie?
Module type P.
Module type P. And the path?
Luna. B3462.
B3462. This is purely routine, sir. It won't be of any interest to you.
On the contrary, Colin, routines are a source of great interest to me. What does this module contain?
Oh, we don't know until we cut it open.
Oh, you must cut it open.
It's damaged.
Welded tight.
And where would you do this cutting?
We lease access to one of the moon base hangars.
Sir, can I get on with the paperwork, please, now? Oh. Well, it's not registered anywhere, so the module and the contents are yours. I'll get you a permit to open. Hazard premium should be through in 2 weeks.
Thanks a lot.
My pleasure. I hope whenever this
turns out
to be a real bonanza for you.
Specimen 274, exposed to the vacuum for 24 hours. No sign of cell damage at all.
Haven't you got a better angle of what he's looking
at? Time check.
The accident and pictures are all we have.
Oh, couldn't you get inside the module, get the rest?
Don't you know what he's doing?
Cell division appears to have continued normally. You are a tough little sucker, aren't you?
Oh my God. He's working on a space bug.
A bacterium. A killer.
Cell division appears to be
one that likes the vacuum as much as it likes the air.
It's exploding!
Lennox was right. You really were bluffing, weren't you? You didn't know a goddamn thing.
What did you do with the module?
Detached it. Dropped it towards the sun. Can you imagine what would have happened if the rest of the station had been exposed to whatever it was he was working on in there?
I knew you must have been paying Hubble to keep his mouth shut, but I had no idea.
It was your payments to him that got us interested in the first place.
Well, hell, we couldn't make Goodman's work public. What he was doing wasn't official.
Well, how come you know so much about it, then?
Well, we found some private notes in his quarters. Hell, the son of a bitch wasn't supposed to be working on germ warfare, for Christ's sakes.
Well, no problem, then.
Yeah, but do you think the Russians would have believed us? If that story had got out, do you think anybody would have believed us?
I doubt it. I don't believe a single word.
Yeah. Well, you know your trouble, boy? You've been hanging around them damn Ruskies for too goddamn long.
So you decided to make Goodman a non-person. He doesn't exist. He never existed.
Well, hell, it wasn't as dumb as it sounds. He had no family. And nobody would care enough to check, huh? And if they did, well, it was a computer bug. Sort of thing that happens all the time, huh? I might never get sorted out.
The system must have been an embarrassment then.
Yes. How did you miss her?
Now, this is where she called from, all right, but she doesn't live here.
Nobody lives here.
This place has been up for sale for over a year.
I spoke to the realtor.
The neighbors.
Nobody's ever met the woman.
Exist. The computer says she does.
Harvey Goodman does exist, and the computer says he doesn't.
Well, if she's not his sister, who the hell is she?
Someone who wants this brought out into the open. Who would benefit from that?
I've been wondering. Why is it welded closed? May I say how impressed I've been by your organization?
Well, I don't think you've seen us quite at our best.
Well, we are alive. That is what is important, is it not?
Yes, we're alive. Anytime you want a job as a detective, Alexander.
Oh, I may avail myself of your invitation, Nathan. I think it would be much more simple than what I am now called on to do.
Yes, I wish you luck.
Спасибо. Suspicum.
Detective, my arse. He knew what was in that thing. He knew all along.
He just asked the right question, Davis.
Yeah, a question I should have asked.
Well, we were none of us very sharp on this one.
Because it was a game. A Russian game. And that old man outplayed us. Us and the Americans, and he might do it again.
I don't think so.
Well, who was the woman then? I mean, if the Russians didn't set her up to expose the Americans, who did?
We seem to be messed about by everyone. Well, even those two Americans have got away with a whole bunch of violations.
Ah, Commander Spring, I presume.
Ah, Miss Goodman. We meet at long last.
Listen, I'm sorry I wasn't around when you called before.
Miss Goodman, there's something I want you to do for me. It could all come out.
Oh, it's not going to come out. Nobody wants it out in the open, for Christ's sakes.
Gentlemen!
What the hell are you doing here?
Oh, well, they let me through to meet you.
What do you want from us?
A little chat. A while back, we had a tip-off from one of your people.
Yeah, about what?
A possible cover-up of some very nasty experiments out in the Ronald Reagan.
Who exactly are you?
Well, my name is Dilly Goodman. No relation, of course. You know what they say. Only the name has been changed to trap the guilty. And did you know that you can change your name quite legally as often as you like?
Do you have some ID?
You might find that a useful tip when you're looking for a new career. Assuming you don't go to jail, of course.
World Press Association.
But I am told that you gentlemen are keen for this whole thing to be dealt with out in the open, though. That and your suggestion that star cops should be appointed to the space station is pretty well bound to count in your favor. And quite honestly, World Press would certainly be behind you on that basis. And now, gentlemen, just a few questions for the people back here on Earth.
In the shadow.